you know how I feel. Ooh, 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 ooh.
Okay, let's see. Looks like this is working. There I am. Oh no, okay. Sort of. You are frozen down there. Let's fix that right now. Oh. Oh, these cameras are backwards. Oops. One second, y'all. Okay, there we go. That's better. And that's better. And now I need to fix one more thing. Here we go. There she is. Okay, people. All right, now, please work. Okay, sweet. Hey, Rita. Hey, Shelly. Hey, Lindsay. Hey, Shayna. Jennifer, Jackie, Claire, Lindsay, sweet. Welcome to everybody that is here. Oh, I forgot to make one more back there. Make one little background change here because it makes a difference. Okay. I've got some news, but it's actually going to kind of work into tonight's class. And it's good. It's not horrible news. When I am sick, one of my first indicators that I'm sick is that my voice drops like 2 octaves. So you do not need to adjust your speaker right now. My voice has literally dropped to this low. I'm not putting this on. This is just what happens when I get sick. And this is the first day of it. And if you're a health nut like me, I hate admitting when I'm sick, but my voice is like the true giveaway. And Tara is also wondering if she's feeling under the weather. So if we seem a little low energy tonight or whatever, that's what's up. Tara said it might be allergies, and I actually think it might be. I am cleaning up so much pollen. I've never had a problem with allergies before, even though my mother is plagued by them. I don't know. I do try to like be outside a lot. Yeah, I do live in the woods, and so maybe I'm pollinated to death. I don't know. But I'm in a good spirit. I'm just physically a little bit low. So anyway, what I wanted to do tonight was teach kind of a sort of a myth and tech type class. And the reason that I want to teach a myth and tech type class is that flow is easier for me when I'm feeling 100%. And what took me so long, actually it took me until I'd been hooping for a long time to understand that method can be a good thing. I've always like sort of rebelled against method and thought that it locked you in or it set you off on a trajectory. But sometimes when you're not feeling it, it's good to sort of have method to like get you through the hoop practice or whatever it is that you're doing. And so like I don't believe in relying on method, but I do believe on, well, I believe in relying on it after you first try, just being inspired and just allowing yourself that freedom. If I, you know, screw my method, once I'm there, I'm there. But if there is no getting there, the method's pretty good. Oh, that's okay. Thank you, guys. I want to just go ahead and jump into class. And so what we're going to do is do kind of a method class for me. I want to talk a little bit about story. I've got some different my Dan in mind that we'll talk about, and we'll do a technique per my Dan, kind of like the super old school way that I used to do it. The classes that you guys have had with me where I'm only talking my Dan and there's not really any woven in technique, that was much, much, much later in my teaching. Like almost always when I would teach the my Dan, the story that I was teaching was related to the technique. And now I have the luxury, I take the luxury of sometimes talking story only. But tonight we're going to talk technique and story to get us through this and kind of rely on this method. So let's go ahead and get into sway. Yeah, here we go. We're going to put Rex away for a second. Audible breath in. Breath in. Breath in. There were no constrictions or restrictions or even conditions to what the Maidan thought about the universe. Each Maidan was allowed and even encouraged to explore their own understanding of the world around them. And so among the Maidan, there were many different sets of beliefs. But in conversation, they discovered that there was a commonality. And that commonality was rhythm. They seemed to all agree that rhythm was a part of their conception of the universe and their spirituality. And they believe that amongst each other that there should be harmony between their rhythm of being and understanding and someone else's. Audible breath. For the Maidan, they didn't really understand tolerance as much as harmony. Audible breath in. When two rhythms were in harmony, the Maidan called that piace. Two separate rhythms creating a third rhythm. Audible breath in. They believe that everything in your life was a piace. Your animals, your loved ones, your habits. And they each applied their individual spirituality to those rhythms. audible breath in. Feeling, Tara? Anything to say? Okay. Hey, Carla. You're here. You are. Okay. Tara says she's enjoying the slow, so we're going to stay there. Oh, I didn't change the background, did I? Oh, sorry, y'all. They are looking at last week's background. I don't know. I like it, though. All right, so after our Zoom class, I wanted to talk a little bit about point technique. Because I wanted to make sure, hey Dorothy, that I had given you all the full advantage of how awesome point technique can be. And sometimes in this medium that we're in, which is awesome and real and sincere, some things can get lost. And I want to make sure that I have set up for you sort of the vibe of point technique. And I thought a little story might help that. And I thought what we would do tonight is start with the hoop in point. We're going to do a point exercise. And start with it on your shoulder. Just hanging from your shoulder. And I want you, I invite you to step into the character of every movement you're doing right now is sacred to you. And that maybe it's even ancient. You can think of it like every way that you move slowly or quickly. It's like pushing away dirt as you dig. The movement of point technique, the reason it's so simple is to help you excavate, really. Audible breath in. I've had many different connections to point technique, but one that I've had, and I just share with you in case it would help you find it, was just pushing my leg into the hoop and creating gooey contact in point. Because that would help me, like, work my balance or in a fun way. Audible breath. For me, I love the idea of exploration and excavation in my hooping. It's about exploring my movement, and then once I find a place, I start digging. Digging to discover. To learn about myself. Technique is using it to help you stretch. Because the hoop's not whirling around you, you can use the hoop to help you stretch, and stretch in a way that feels good to you. I usually don't have much to say to you, but is there anything you'd like to say? I want to make sure I give you an opportunity. Okay. For a lot of reasons, one of my favorite characters of the Maidan is Saza the Illuminated. She's the first spiritual Maidan. She brings that spiritual thirst to Anna. I should say she probably quenches what Anna didn't realize was a spiritual thirst. Sansa came from a tribe of holy people, where the women and the men were both equally holy. Unfortunately, they were in the minority and were constantly on the run, and in battle, Sansa gets separated from them and believes that they have perished, and they most likely have. And so Sansa feels in her heart this real responsibility to carry on the tribe, to not just be one of many, but to be many within one. Audible breath in. And one of Sansa's favorite point techniques was to fly with wind. And we can work on this technique by spinning the hoop horizontally. But we're using the backs of our hands to help us hold it in place. And this is a super old school Sansa exercise, which is, I'm holding the hoop in point here, and I'm going to spin the hoop up, pinky to pinky, and then put the point hoop back to sleep in point, without letting it cling against the body. This is a flow class. Well, it's a tech class, but it's a myth tech class. So the idea is that you're allowed to take off on a runway when you get there. But as I was saying in the beginning, if we're talking method, for me, I would use this exercise, if I'm not feeling it, to feel my horizontal point flow. To keep it that simple, to just feel horizontal. And I can bring the hoop on me and start to introduce some core hooping if that's what I'm feeling. And I can bring it off. I can knock and reverse.
Vulnerable. forgetful, losing self-confidence, petty, irritable, fear of the future, obsessed with possessions, meaninglessness, friendlessness, fear of being penniless, no one to touch, loss of psychological power, because there is change afoot. Be with the changes, and at the same moment, cultivate equanimity, spaciousness, emptiness, awareness, clarity. May it be so.
Exercise. How are you doing? Sometimes, guys, as a hooper, you know, like you get in your own zone, and sometimes I have to come back to y'all. That's what just happened to me. Okay. All right, so I thought we would do some core hooping now. And we're going to go ahead, and I'm going to just play the music. Yeah. Huh. Well, then you are painting a picture. Yeah, nice, Jennifer. Nice, Dorothy. Thank you for your comments, guys. Sweet. I'm glad you guys are digging the vibe. All right. Let's do some core hooping. We're not gonna do a huge amount. I want tonight's class to be pretty gentle, but we're going to do a little bit. Because I want to talk about Ana. And sometimes it can help if you close your eyes so that you can really feel this, but you can keep them open, whatever feels good to you. The story of Ana, she is Ana the runner. And she runs from a situation into nothing because she can't take the situation anymore. And so she has this energy about her, which is very brave and very assertive. She's your friend that you might have had in the past or have now that, like, says, just do it. Just do the thing. Just do it. That's Ana energy. Anyway, in core hooping, we imagine that Ana is running around us. That the hoop, as it's traveling around us, is someone literally running around us. And so when we are dancing with Ana, when we are moving with the runner, trying to make their run, like feeling how our different rhythm changes their run,
That's a type of piace. And where it can really come in handy is when you want to start to learn to chi the hoop up, which means to bring the hoop up without touching it. Because connecting to the path of contact at the point of every step of a na will help you do that, because you'll start to visualize the path. You'll think like, oh, how is this running thing going to get up to my shoulders? I'm going to have to visualize that path and send it up there. And then however I want to get it down, I get it down. And maybe I don't just get in the habit of going up and down, but maybe just every now and then I come up with a na just to show that I can. Now there are some tricks. The hardest way to do this is standing completely still, like Tara's doing right now. But I can chi the hoop by turning with the current. If I turn with the current, allow myself to turn. Tara's just showing off at this point. Actually, Tara's saying that this was a helpful hint. She's feeling an ah running around right now. But you feel that path, you come up. If you are not getting that as well as Tara, what you can do is turn with the hoop as you're bringing it up. And sometimes that can help you get the hoop more up. Ah, sweet Shelly. One more way that we can work with this image of a na, and we can do it in angle hooping, and we're going to do about 2 more minutes of this. So if your heart rate's up, don't worry, we're not going to stay here too long. But in the same way, well, maybe if you hopefully in the same way that you're visualizing the path of a na and you're bringing her up or bringing her down, you can start to tilt her. Okay, so right now, if you guys are with my metaphor, you would be seeing a na running like around me at a 90 degree angle, like just sort of perfectly running around me. If I wanted to make her run in an earth angle, I would have to tilt the surface that she's running around. And so I can visualize that tilt and then still keep my connection to her every step. Now what you're going to notice is that once you get into the angle, then it becomes just good old-fashioned, you know, old-school ana hooping, right? Like once you get here, it's not too different. You just have to remember to move left and right, up and down, left and right, up and down. Like maybe not in that order, but there's got to be some left, some right, and some up and down to hold the angle. Now when it's time to bring ana back, like if you want to bring her back to what in hoop path we call lake, then you can just start wrapping her around your waist and she'll automatically flatten. And then again, she's running around me. If I want to make sure she's running on top of me, what would I have to do? I would have to bend backwards and let her run on top of me. But then I have to get underneath her steps so that she's not sliding. I would dip my first tree, my AM side. I would dip my, if I'm going to the left, I'd dip my right side. If I'm going to the right, my left side. I would dip that side into the current to help hold her, to give her kind of the best path across. And then I'm going to try to walk a knob back down into earth. And this is called a chi cycle. So we're going to see if we can do this together. I'm in earth. And then I'm going to try, over time, I'm taking my time to walk a knob back into sky.
without touching the hoop, without moving my feet. It can take as much time as it needs to, that's not the point. So I'm in sky now, it doesn't matter how much in sky I am, I am in a sky angle. Now I'm gonna walk a knob back into earth. I'm gonna take my time, so I'm not gonna flub it up or anything like that. Oop. So these are chi, this is called chi in an angle. And I'm doing it in my first current right now. I'm gonna get to the bottom here, and I'm just gonna go ahead and start off in second current. Now I know for a fact that I can do this. I did it earlier today. But this is a good way to learn your second current. And you might discover that your second current is sometimes better at changing angles than your first current. So I'm in second current. I'm gonna keep doing these angle chis. It's badass once you get it. This is one of those hoop moves that nobody that watches you do it will realize how hard it was to learn or to master. Nice. Okay. How are you feeling? Are you tired? Are you doing good?
I'm good as long as we're not going to do core hooping again.
We're not going to do core hooping again on the next song. Tara says she's good as long as we're not doing core hooping. Nice. Sweet. Yeah, it's good to film your practices, y'all.
Nice.
We got some breakthroughs happening tonight. That's awesome. All right. I can't remember if this song has really bad language, but I do kind of like it. Okay, so I thought we would... I thought we would give our cores a break and do some good old-fashioned Kaya hooping right now. Samurai comes into the whole Maidan lore because Kaya battles three samurais. Of all the people that she ever encountered in her witch makeup and disguise and regalia, only three humans ever decided to stand toe-to-toe with her, and they were three samurai. And they fight to a draw. And then they decide to basically make dinner and learn from each other. What they learned from Kaya was fluidity. Kaya had no technique as they did. She only had like instinct and movement. And what Kaya got from them was the mappings of their explorations. And what I mean by that is that she could see where they had decided maybe move both hands, maybe think of form. And these goals that were awkward actually led to kind of a resource. And so when we hoop in samurai in the sort of spirit, oh, hey, there's Mimi.
if the lyrics get rough on this, I'm gonna turn it. Okay. Me.
I got high in the basement, finding my replacement. Days went by, all that mattered was a basement. Ain't shit you could do or say to make me change my mind. I got time, you get yours, I'll get mine. I had lines waiting on me, on chicks who didn't know me. Had to get that shit up, cause that sniff would make my nose bleed. Oh geez, got a nigga saying, oh please, would it speak a thousand words if the picture don't freeze? How could I fear a nigga if we both bleed? Same color blood, we keep what? Let you smoke the sticky bud. Ain't no use for fisticuffs, cause one of us gon' get fucked up, I swear. And I'll do anything if double dare. This a physical challenge and this is double dare. Ask your friends if you're in trouble, I pull up, they be like, yeah. I'm a bad motherfucker, who's that motherfucker? Here's another great track, take that motherfucker. I've been running. Job down for more than 3 months. Guess it is my fault, cause I smoke too many blunts. Never had a problem fitting in, cause I've been cool as shit since I was a little kid. Around the age of 10 is when all my uncles try to school me, taught me how to fight Casey's
whenever
niggas
you find
try to
yourself
bully me
stuck.
Cause I ain't never felt this
warrior or anything who pathway in hooping ways, you can change your footwork and you can drastically change your footwork, and warrior style at this kind of flow is the perfect way to do that. And what I mean by that, like, if I'm not sure what to do, I can just take a big step. I can just make a drastic action. Sweep my feet across the floor.
If they never notice that, then they don't know me that well. Look beyond the surface. Fuck it, I ain't perfect, but it sells. I've been running.
It's like, for those of you that want to find your own moves, that want to feel your, and have your own movement, sometimes it can help to push yourself into new territory and then react to it. And that's where the moves come from. It's like the newness is actually this new earth that you might find a move in. So as awkward as it may seem, force yourself into awkward movements and sometimes you'll find something.
I'd be like, no, nothing. What made you think that? It couldn't have been this pink bat, could it? I guess it could. My vision isn't good, but I wish a nigga would take a swing. Now watch the space nigga do his thing. I can handle anything, I ain't scared of anything. Grab an alligator by the jugular and make him sing. Go home and catch a boner, fuck your mom and be like, swing. Ladies holler at me, lately you can page me. Code 69's both fun and amazing. Rhyming hasn't paid me more than you make daily, so quit trying to play me, tell me that I'm changing. You think I'm working this hard to do the same thing I was a year ago. Y'all ain't thinking clearly, so I'm like, hell no. But I don't think y'all hear me though, so I figured out the answer. Like the here it go. I've been running. I've been running.
Oh no, you're deck hooping, sweet. That's awesome. Okay. Yeah, let's see. Boom. Okay, I think we are going to free hoop it from here. Because I believe we started it. Okay, so we started more or less on time. And since we're already kicked off of Facebook, I'm positive we'll just stay with the flow here. I think we're going to keep it in the hip-hop range, and then we're going to tone it down. But this will be the free hoop here.
They say if you ain't got no money.
me take your broke ass.
Ma say if you got you $2, then come through to my party. But get bent before you come, cause for that liquor I'll be charging. And take down these directions, it's right past that intersection. Make a right at the light, it's the first house on the left hand. Get it, got it good, you made it, I knew you would. We got them drinks up in the back, and them chickies looking good. Hold up, here come one. Hey, what's your name, hun? Jackie Brown, yeah, that pop. Hey, I'm Chuck, this Mikey Rocks. And let me introduce you to some kids that you ain't used to. Yep, we definitely ride bikes. Aaron Bones and Jordan Fives got every single color. So just in case you wonder, my parties is always live as a mother. It's for supper in the summer when it's hotter than the oven. We the coolest kids we know, so you know we into something that involved doing something with a trunk to get that bass drum pumping. It's my party, so get up. If you don't, you get in jail.
What's happening? Hey, where's the party? Say you heard me say it, it's a party right around my way. So if you finna start it, then don't do nothing small. Get everyone involved and say that it's a party. What's happening? Hey, where's the party? Say you heard me say that it's a party right around my way. So if you finna start it, then don't do nothing small. Get everyone involved and say that it's a party.
One to the two, three to the four. Chucky and Mike is at your door. We don't knock, we straight on that.
When your album's right,
you can wait on that. I don't like the questions you ask, so let me tell you a little bit about myself. Everywhere I go, I act the ass. And if you ain't know, better go and ask. At every party, I hop the bar and then dance with the chicks on top of that. Boston to be like, get off of that. I'm like, not till I get rich off a rap. Then I look to the left, she dipping her hips and licking her lips at me, I guess. Then I look to the left, look to the right, point to my chest, she was like, that's right. Now let me tell you the recipe to all you niggas trying to get like me. It takes a scoop of being cool, and the rest will be included when you purchase my movie. Cause if you knew what I knew, you would probably try to do whatever I do. Probably move to Chicago if you want instructions, and I could probably front them just as long as you shorties pay attention. So if you ugly, keep your hands by your side. But if you not, then put them in the sky. And if you knowin' what it is, it's a party at the crib. Come and party with the kids.
What's
like,
what's happening? Hey, where's the party? Say you heard me say it, it's a party right around my way. So if you finna start it, then don't do nothing small. Get everyone involved and say that it's a party. What's happening? Hey, where's the party? Say you heard me say that it's a party right around my way. So if you finna start it, then don't do nothing small. Get everyone involved and say that it's a party.
Okay, we are going to chill it down a bunch now. Like a lot. Thank you guys for joining us tonight. If you want to stay with us, this song's going to be super chill. This is kind of a stretchy, slow movement type song. Kind of. Anyway, thank you guys for joining us. That's great, Jen. Thank you, Rita. Thank you, Shelly. Thank you. guys have a wonderful evening. Thanks, Tara, for being a part. Good night to you guys. And, oh, we will not have class Thursday. We will not have, I forgot to announce that at the beginning. There is no class this Thursday. But thank you guys for joining me now. It makes this one even more special. Things just came up. I can't teach on Thursday. I'm sorry about that. But I will be back Monday, guys. Thank you.